Hello, good day to our grade 10 Galileo students from the Laboratory High School. This morning or today, we will be having our discussion on the lesson 1 of Mathematics 10, which is the patterns and sequences. But before that, I want you to have this hugot line. And it goes like this. Ang pag-move on daw ay parang math lang yan. Mahirap pag-aralan. Pero, kailangan. So, kung nasaktan ka ngayon, mag-move on ka lang. Alam ko, masakit yan, pero kailangan mong pag-aralan kung paano mag-move on para gift mo na rin yon sa sarili mo, sa family mo, sa iyong mga friends. Ang gawin mo na lang ay ipag-pray mo yung mga taong nanakit sa'yo na sana ay mapatawad mo sila at para ikaw ay makapag-move on. So like for example, the pandemic that we are facing right now, masakit para sa karamihan sa atin, but we have to learn how to move on. Ituring natin siya na parang mathematics lang, no? Medyo mahirap, pero kailangan natin siyang pag-aralan. Because that's life. We have to accept that, okay? So we move on to the patterns and sequences. Patterns refer to usual types of procedures or rules that can be followed. Patterns are useful to predict what came before or what might come after a set of numbers that are arranged in a particular order. And also in our daily lives, we can look into different patterns into our lives. May mga panahon na swerte kung ngayong araw, no? Swerte ulit ako lupa. So baka sa susunod, swerte ulit ako. So something like that. And also, the patterns in natures, we can also observe some patterns in natures, patterns in the leaves, patterns into the skin of the animals, patterns into the nature. So this arrangement of numbers is called a sequence. So arrangement of number is what we call a sequence. For example, 3, 6, 9, 12, and 15 are numbers that form a pattern called a sequence. So, there is a pattern, 3, 6, 9, 12, and 15. And that pattern is what we call a sequence. The numbers that are in the sequence are called terms. In this sequence, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, how many terms do we have? So there are 5 terms, and the terms are 3, 6, 9, 12, and 15. So there are 2 different types of sequences. The first one is the arithmetic sequence or the arithmetic progression. It is a sequence of numbers in which the difference between any 2 consecutive numbers or expressions is the same. So, we may say that a sequence is an arithmetic sequence if and only if the difference between any two consecutive numbers are the same. So, like for example, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. The difference between 3 and 6 is 3. The difference between 6 and 9 is also 3. The difference between 9 and 12 is also 3. So, the difference between any 2 consecutive numbers of the sequence are the same, which is equal to 3. So we may say that sequence is an example of arithmetic sequence. Another type of sequence is the geometric sequence. A sequence of numbers in which each term is formed by multiplying the previous term by the same number or expression. So, in the arithmetic sequence, we are looking into the common difference. Here, in geometric sequence, we are looking basically into the common multiplier of each term. So, the common multiplier must be congruent, must be equal of any 2 consecutive numbers. Like for example, we have 1, 3, 9, 27. 1, 3, 9, 27. We multiply 1 by 3, so you'll have 3. You multiply 3 by 3, so you will have 9. You multiply 9 by 3, so you will have 27. So, the common multiplier in that sequence is 3. So, that means that 1, 3, 9, 27 is an example of a geometric sequence. So, let us dig deeper into the arithmetic sequence. So find the next three terms or terms in each pattern. Suppose that letter A, we have 7, 12, 17, 22. So as you can see, this is an example of arithmetic sequence. Our task is to find the next three terms or three numbers or three terms in each pattern. So the first step is to look for a pattern, or usually a procedure or rule that uses the same number or expression each time to find the next term. The pattern is to add 5 to each term, because upon looking at this sequence, we know or we may observe that 12 minus 7 is 5, 17 minus 12 is 5, 22 minus 17 is 5 also. So the common difference is 5. So we always add 5 in each term to get the next number. So upon adding 5, you will have 22 plus 5, which is 27. 27 plus 5 equals 32. And 32 plus 5 equals 37. So the next three terms are 27, 32, and 37. So those are the next three terms or three numbers in the arithmetic sequence. Another example, find the next three numbers or terms in each pattern. As we can see, in here, we have a decreasing pattern or a decreasing sequence. 45, 42, 39, 36. So let us look into the pattern. So the pattern is to add a negative integer since it's in decreasing order. So you will have 45 and 42. The difference is negative 3. Then the difference is negative 3. The difference is negative 3. So the common difference here is negative 3. So the next three terms would be 36 plus negative 3, which is 33. Or we subtract 3 to get the next terms. 36 minus 3 is 33. 33 minus 3 is 30. And then 30 minus 3 is 27. So that's the next three terms. So you will have 45, 42, 39, 36, 33, 30, and 27. How about for the geometric sequence? Let's have an example. Find the next three terms or terms in each pattern. So you have 3, 9, 27, 81. So we have to look for the pattern. So the pattern here in this geometric sequence is to multiply 3 to each term, because as you can see, 3 times 3 is 9, 9 times 3 is 27, 27 times 3 is 81. So basically, to get the next term, you multiply 81 by 3. So that's the common multiplier. The common multiplier is 3. So the next three terms are 81 times 3, which is 243. 243 times 3 is 729. Then 729 by 3 is 2187. Completing the geometric sequence, you will have 45. You will have 3, 9, 27, 81, 243, 729, and 2187. Another example, find the next three numbers or terms in each pattern. So 528, 256, 128, and 64. In this case, the geometric sequence is in decreasing order. So that means we are looking for, instead of looking for a common multiplier, we look for a common divisor. Okay? So in this pattern, the common divisor is 2. So to get 256, we divide 528 by 2. To get 128, we divide 256 by 2. To get 64, we divide 128 by 2. So technically, to get the next term, we divide 64 by 2. So we have to take note that to divide by a number is the same as multiplying by its reciprocal. So since our divisor here is 2, So the reciprocal of 2 is 1 half. So we can also multiply the sequence by 1 half to get the next term, or simply divide it by 2. So there you go. The next three terms would be 64 divided by 2 is equal to 32. Then 32 divided by 2 is equal to 16. And then 16 divided by 2 is equal to 8. So our geometric sequence, 528, 256, 128, 64, 32, 16, and 8. Let us have another example for geometric sequence. Find the next three expressions or terms in each pattern. So 2m, 4m, 8m, 16m. So in this case, there is already a variable, and the variable is m. So again, we have to look for the pattern. So in this pattern, we simply multiply the previous term by 2 to get the next term, because our common multiplier here is 2. So the next three terms would be 16m times 2 is equal to 32m. 32m times 2 is equal to 64m. And then 64m times 2 is equal to 128m. So our geometric sequence would be 2m, 4m, 8m, 16m, 32m, 64m, and 128m. Reference for this PowerPoint presentation is the www.primaryresources.com. If you have any more questions with regards to patterns and sequences, please do not hesitate to send me a message in our group chat, Mathematics 10 Galileo. Once again, thank you very much. God bless, keep healthy and safe, and hope to see you soon.